Kevon, let me say welcome to Our Naturalist Live. Thanks for writing such a powerful message that I know that has moved a lot of people. So first, tell the listeners a little bit about yourself, your background.
Yeah, I'm Kevon Ellis. I'm 20 years old. I attend the Media Technology Institute at CPTT. I am studying journalism right now, / video production, and I'm from Almontown, Kingston, Jamaica.
What transpired that made you decide to write this wonderful piece?
You know, I was in downtown Kingston one day with my father, who is a vendor there.
Mm-hmm.
And the police officers, you know, came along and take away the vendor's stuff because, you know, they were at an illegal spot, including my dad. But I thought that they could deal with it more better, you know, not in that aggressive way, you know. So instantly I decided that I was going to write about it. And, you know, the part about experience was one of the things that was always puzzling me over the years. So, you know, I just decided to start writing.
The part where you say that they say you need experience, but they won't give you the job, and realize that you need a job to get experience. So what has been the response like towards this question that you asked? Why?
The response overall are just that particular part.
The entire concept, the entire poem?
Yeah, the responses have been great. You know, as I say, it is the sad truth in Jamaica, and actually it's a sad truth around the world. So the response is great, and I mean, that was surprising. And people are saying, you know, everything I spoke about is what is happening for real, you know, experience, teenage pregnancy, and all that. So, you know, the response is really great from everyone.
How long did it take you? You're 20 years old. Is this your first foray into writing something, into writing a poem, or you have done this before on a smaller scale?
Actually, I write sports news sometimes, but this is my first poetry.
Oh, this is your first poetry. And my brother, you hit the nail right on the head. And, you know, when I first heard this, I saw someone post on Facebook, and I'm like, I had to speak to you because, you know, so many times we are saying that, you know, the young, we, you know, they're this and they're that. And here you are, a young man that's doing positive stuff. And I definitely thought it was a chance for me to actually, you know, expose you a little bit further to those in the U.S. And hopefully they can listen to your work and, you know, get to, you know, love your work. Now, in the poem, it says, you said that you want to be the change that Jamaica needs.
Yes, I did.
So, how are you going to go about you being that change?
Actually, just the other day, I went to the Maxfield Children Home. Me and my team, you know, went there to do some donation, donate tin stuffs, we donate clothes, we donate books to the basic school there. So, that's just one of the changes I'm making already.
Mm-hmm. No, that's definitely a big step, you know, lending your talent now, because now you're becoming famous, and a lot of folks are going to, you know, demand your attention. But as always, just always keep it real. Now, when I was watching the video, you know, and to the end of the video, you started saying that, you know, don't judge a book by the cover. Let me just kind of give the folks an idea what the video is like. He's in a black room, he's in a suit and tie, looking all presidential, so to speak. But at the end of the video, he said, don't judge a book by the cover. And you end up sitting on the stoop of a home. I don't know if that is your home or that is just someone else's home. But just for the visual, that was very powerful. Why did you decide to make that statement right there and have that kind of visual?
Yeah, I mean, because in all of the video, except that section, I was in a necktie looking more formal, like I'm going to work. So, you know, I'm showing them that. You know, with the background, with the outfit that I'm in, you can't judge the book by the cover. You have to read the back of the book. So, you know, that was the reason why, mainly to show them that, yes, I can be in that also. Not only formal, but also, you know, yard style and all that. So I just decided to do it like that.
In case you just joined us, we are talking to Kevon Ellis. He has a spoken word. It is called Why. You can find it on YouTube. It is very, very powerful. And we have the young man live from Jamaica on the phone right now. So as you go along, what are some of the challenges that you have come across as you try to spread your message?
In trying to spread the message?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, as I said in the piece, experience, actually I'm unemployed right now, you know, so... That is one of the challenges. I got people to spread the video viral, the audio and SoundCloud and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it actually reached some of the top media personnel in Jamaica, like Failington and and all those persons there, but in, maybe the politicians have heard it before, you know, but sometimes they just don't pay it any mind. But as I said in the piece, I'm going to be the change, so I'm not going to wait on what the politicians are going to do. I'm just going to go up there and do what I'm doing already and just try to be the change.
I haven't, like young kids, you know, came up to you and be like, oh, man, I really love this, and it has inspired me and, you know, make me want to change.
Yeah, a lot of persons my age group and even younger have inspired persons that might be in all age groups. So, I mean, it's a good feeling, you know, to see young ones coming up to me asking the same questions you are asking, what inspired, why, what are the changes I'm going to make in Jamaica. So, yeah, there are a lot of persons, school children, the part that I talk about being suspended,
mm-hmm.
when that's the same thing happened in Parliament, they love that part. The part about weed that touches the youth in the streets who are smoking ganja and all that. And I mean, the experience is the major part that affects almost everyone.
All right. So, you know, before, you know, because we are on Roblox Radio in New Jersey, DJNaturalist.com, also Fresh Radio in Atlanta. Why don't you give out your information, like where folks can contact you?
Oh, my email address is Kevon_Ellis@yahoo.com. You can find me on Facebook at I am Kevon Ellis and on Instagram at I am Kevon Ellis. So you can find me there.
No, give it one more time, because some folks, you know, they write kind of slow.
Email address is Kevon_Ellis@yahoo.com. You can find me on Facebook at I am Kevon Ellis, or you can find me on the same Facebook at Kevon Ellis, or you can find me on Instagram at I am Kevon Ellis.
Where do you see yourself, say, in another 5 years? Right now you said you're unemployed. I'm sure I ask the question. What is the biggest obstacle right now to you being employed?
I mean, as I said, experience. A lot of youth, including myself, have CXC subjects, you know. So, I mean, it's just experience. That is a major problem right now. And sometimes because of our geographical background, they don't employ you. So that is the big challenge right now. So most of the youth is either you have to have some links or some sort of that.
So experience and your geographical background, meaning if you come from the ghetto and, you know, it's less likely that somebody that's uptown would actually want to hire you. And I remember back in the days, Etana did a song that's called, I believe it was Wrong Address, kind of dealing with the same issues. Well, I tell you, it doesn't matter your geographical location. The work you are doing right now, continue to do it. And I'm pretty sure that you're going to sow your seed and you will reap some wonderful fruits from what you're doing right now. You have inspired me, and I know you have inspired a lot of other folks also. So continue doing what you're doing, all right?
Yeah, thank you, and thanks for having me.
Massive, that is it right there. That is Kevon Ellis, and he has the big spoken word where he asks a simple question, why? And I can use that one word right there, why, and ask a lot of other questions that is very important to people's lives. So make sure we keep in touch, and if you're ever in the States, make sure you give me a link, all right, so we can continue the conversation. All right, I'll check up on you in a couple of weeks or a couple of months, all right, to see how things still going. All right, all right, no doubt about it.
Thanks again.
No problem, you're welcome. That is the man right there. Yes, yeah, sometimes you gotta do it a little bit different. Instead of always talking to an artist, talk to somebody else that's doing good things in the community. And of course, his name is Kevon Ellis, and he has the big spoken word. It's simple, call. Why?
Why is it that age of consent is 16, but if you're not 18, you can't vote or have a driver's license? So the only benefit of being age of consent is to have sex, and then uno same one criticize teenage pregnancy. Uno same one lock up my little brother for a bag of weed, but you're selling Whistler. Why? Why the human rights pretend to protect the human rights when many of the human doesn't know their rights until you're in front of your honor to be sentenced for life? Why my sister has been deprived of the numerous benefits in society because of her geographical background? She's been stigmatized to possess no quality.
What you want to be when you grow up? People better be, better people, never say. What you want to